to the latest in that alarming story of the six-year-old Virginia boy who shot his teacher. His family is breaking their silence, speaking for the first time since the shooting. Janae Norman has the details. Good morning, Janae.
Michael, good morning. This story had so many people talking. The family now saying their heart goes out to their son's teacher and that she selflessly served her students and thanking her for her courage, grace, and sacrifice. They say their family has been committed to responsible gun ownership and keeping firearms out of the reach of children. So there are so many questions that remain over how that gun got into the hands of a child.
This morning, regret for the family of the first grader accused of shooting his teacher.
Female victim, she's been shot in the abdomen as well as a through and through into the hand.
The nation stunned earlier this month when Newport News, Virginia police responded to Richneck Elementary School for a six-year-old who'd opened fire. The family now revealing in a statement to ABC News, our son suffers from an acute disability and was under a care plan at the school that included his mother or father attending school with him and accompanying him to class every day. The week of the shooting was the first week when we were not in class with him. We will regret our absence on this day for the rest of our lives. Police say the first grader took his mother's legally purchased 9mm handgun from home and fired one round at 25-year-old Abigail Zwerner as she taught the elementary students.
It felt like something out of a really bad nightmare.
Desiree Yvette's daughter was one of the more than a dozen children in that classroom.
She's scared because Ms. Zwerner is her favorite girl. She would always say it and... For her to get shot, my daughter doesn't know anymore, like, who's safe, and she's scared that the people she loves will get hurt.
The family telling ABC News they have been cooperating with local and federal law enforcement, adding that the firearm our son accessed was secured. Police still investigating how the six-year-old got a hold of the gun, and questions mounting after school leaders told parents they got a tip that the student had a weapon, even searched his backpack, but didn't find the firearm before Zwerner was shot. Terrified parents and faculty members voiced frustrations at a recent school board meeting.
I send my kids to school and find myself praying to God that they will return home safely.
Our students do not wonder if there will be another school shooting. They wonder when and where the next shooting will be.
And we've heard the teachers back home recovering. But guys, it is the issue of the school being tipped off about that student possibly having a weapon, even searching his backpack and not finding it, that really has parents there so upset, even calling for the superintendent to resign, guys.
All right, Janae Norman for us. So many questions still in that case.